Thanks. Before my presentation, can I take a photo from here? Okay. Thanks. Okay. Who am I? At first, let me introduce myself. My name is Takayuki Shimizukawa, came from Japan. I do three open source works. First one is Sphinx co-maintainer since the end of 2011. And the second is organized Sphinx users JP user group in Japan. And third is a member of Python JP committee. And I'm working for Bilbao, the company. Our company develops web applications for business customers with using Django, Pyramid, SQL Alchemy, Sphinx, and other Python-related tools. Before my main presentation, I'd like to introduce PyCon JP 2011, 2015 in Tokyo, Japan. We will hold the event in this October. Registration is open. Please join us. Please come to Japan. Anyway, Sphinx autodoc. Sphinx autodoc, this is the main topic of this session. Autodoc is a feature that is automated document generation from source code. Autodoc uses function definitions and also uses docstrings of the such functions. Before we jump into the main topic, I want to know how many people know the docstring and how many people are writing the docstrings. Do you know docstring is a feature of Python? Do you know the docstring? How many people know that? Oh, almost people know. Thanks. And maybe 80 hands raised. Okay. This you know this is this red line is a docstring. And docstrings describe a way of using the function that is written as the first line in the function body. When you type help dumps for dumps function in a Python interactive shell, you will get the docstring. Second question is, how you written API docs as docstrings? Please raise again. API docs, maybe half of people using API docs. Thanks. Okay. But I think half of people does not use writing API document by using a docstring. So what is the reason you don't know write them? Someone will say, I don't know what or where should I write them? Or are there some specific docstring formats? Or it's not beneficial. For example, sometimes docstrings are not updated even the function's behavior is changed. Those opinions are understandable. And so then I'll explain you how to write the docstrings. Goal of this session is how to generate a doc from Python source code, and the second one is rediscovering the meaning of docstrings. Okay, let's move forward. Sphinx autodoc is the most useful way to activate docstrings. So before talking about docstrings, I'll introduce a basic of Sphinx and how to set up it. What is Sphinx? Sphinx is a documentation generator. Sphinx generates doc as several output formats from restructured text markup that is extensible. And the story of a history of Sphinx. This man is Georg Brandl is the father of Sphinx. Until 2007, Python official document was written by LaTeX. But it's too hard to maintain. Georg was trying to change the, such situation. So then, he created the Sphinx in 2007. The Sphinx provides ease of use and maintainability for the Python official document. Sphinx before and after. Before, there was no standard way to write documents. One example is a Python official document. It was written by LaTeX and several some Python scripts Django. And sometimes we need to convert markups into other formats. Since Sphinx has been released, we can generate more multiple output formats from single source, and integrated HTML tables makes read docs easier, and API reference can be integrated into narrative docs. And automated docs building and hosting, automated doc buildings and hosting by read the doc service. Nowadays, Sphinx has been used by these libraries and tools already displayed. Python library, Python, Sphinx, Flux, Django, Jinja2, Django, Pyramid, SQL Alchemy, NumPy, SciPy, Scikit-learn, Pandas, Fabric, Ansible, AWS CLI. And now, non-Python library tools also using Sphinx for them, like Chef, or CakePHP, or MassJax, Selenium, Vanish, so on. Sphinx provides this extension to support automated API documentation. Sphinx X autodoc and autosummary doc test coverage. Autodoc is the most important feature of Sphinx. Almost Python-related libraries are using the autodoc feature. Okay, let's set up a Sphinx project for this code, for example. This library, example library, will be used in place of your code to explain autodoc feature. The library name is DeepSort, for example. And this is the structure of the library. The library has three modules, api.py, calc.py, and utils.py. Second box is first line of program code in utils.py. If you don't have Sphinx installation in your environment, you need to install the Sphinx by this command, pip install Sphinx. Please note that your source code and Sphinx should be installed in single Python environment. Python version is also important. If you install Sphinx into Python 3 environment, in spite of your code is written by Python 2, autodoc will emit exception to import your Python 2 source code by Python 3 Sphinx. Once you install the Sphinx, you can generate your documentation scaffold by using Sphinx quick start command. Then interactive wizard is invoked as it requires project name, author name, and project version. The wizard also asks you many questions, but usually all you need is keep pressing Enter key. Note that hyphen M option is important for this session because if you invoke wizard the option wizard this hyphen M option, you will get a hard coded make targets for in the make file. That really will annoy you. And my presentation slide stands on this option. This option is introduced since Sphinx 1.3, and hyphen M option will become default from Sphinx 1.5. So type make HTML in doc directory to generate HTML output. You can see the output in underscore build slash HTML directory like this. This is the output example. Now you can see the directory file structure like this. Library files and the deep sort, directory, build output and doc directory. Scaffold files and doc directory too. In particular, you will see where utils.py, conf.py, and index rest in this session, these yellow files. Now we're ready to go. Generate API docs from your Python source code. Set up Sphinx autodoc extensions. This is a conf.py file in your Sphinx scaffold. What is important is third and fifth lines, red lines. Third line is add your library path to import them from Sphinx autodoc. Line five is add Sphinx ext autodoc to use the extension. Next, let's specify the module you want to document. This is add auto module directive to your docs. First box is a utils file that is a part of deep thought example library. Second box is a rest file. You can see the auto module usage in this box. Auto module is a Sphinx directive syntax that is provided by autodoc extension to generate document. This is the second box. I cannot click. Okay. Line four is auto module directive import specified module and inspect it. In this case, deepthought.utils module will be imported and be inspected. And line five is members option. We'll inspect all members of module, not only just the module docstring. Okay, we are now all ready. Let's invoke make.html again. So, as a last result of make.html, you can get an automatically generated document from .py file, like this. Internally, AutoModule directive inspects your module and renders the function signature, arguments, and docstrings. How do it work? AutoDoc directive generates intermediate REST like this. Actually, intermediate file is not generated in your file system, just created on memory. If you want to see the intermediate rest of lines, you can use -vvv options like this. Sphinx ops equal -vvv for make HTML command line. As you see, auto module directive is replaced with concrete document contents. But please take care. Sphinx autodoc import your code to get docstrings. If it means autodoc will execute code at module global level, let me introduce a bad case related to this. This module will remove all your files. And danger.py was designed as a command line script instead of import from other module. If you try to document with using autodoc, delete world function will be called by a global line. Consequence of this, make HTML will destroy all your files. On the other hand, safer.py lower line green blocks using execution guard. If underscore name equal main, it's very famous Python idiom, I think. Because of the execution guard, your file will not be removed by make.html. As a particular matter, you shouldn't try to document your setup.py for a packaging module for your package with using autodoc. Now, let's return to the docstring and its output. This output lacks necessary information. It is information of the argument. If you are looking for an API reference and you find it, you will say, if you find like this library reference, you will say, oh, I can understand the type of argument and meaning even reading this. In this case, you can use info field list syntax for describing arguments. A real docstring should have a description for each function argument like this. These red parts are special version of field list syntax that called info field list. The specification of info field list is described as the URL page, this page. Info field list is rendered as this. The output is quite nice. So you will say, oh, I can understand it, maybe. And cross reference to functions. You can easily make cross reference from other location to the dumps function. Of course, the cross reference is beyond the pages. So far, I introduced the basics of autodoc. Following subject is detect deviations of the implementation and the document by using docstring. By using doctest. I think a good ABI has a good document that illustrates usages of the API by using a code example. If doc has a code example, you can grasp the API usage quickly and exactly. I add the code example search for red lines to docstring area. It's called doctest block. Obviously, this looks like is interactive content of the Python interactive shell. Actually, you can copy and paste the red lines from Python interactive shell. After make HTML, you can get a syntax highlighted doctest blocks like this. Library users can grasp the API usage quickly and exactly, and also users can try out it easily. And the point of view from library developers, code example is very close from the implementation. We can expect that library developers will update code example when the interface is changed by themselves. Really? Sorry, I don't believe it. If the code example was very close from implementation, developers wouldn't mind to it because developers have no spare time to read the implicit rules from the code. Explicit is better than implicit for us. Okay, let's use the doctest builder to detect deviations of the implementation and the documentation. To use doctest builder, you need to add a Sphinx doctest extension to conf.py like this. Add a Sphinx extra doc test line. With only this, you are ready to use the doc test builder. Okay, let's invoke make doc test command. After that, you can see the dumps function will provide us different results from the expected one, like this. Expected one is spam, one ham, egg. And actual one is to be implemented strings that is returned from dumps function. I think it is not implemented properly yet. Anyway, by using the doctest builder, it shows us differences in implementation and sample code in the documentation. Actually, if you your unit test also contains doc tests, you don't need to do this by Sphinx side. However, if you don't write the unit test yet, make doc test would be a good place to start. Next is listing APIs automatically with using autosummary. As already noted, autodoc is very useful. However, if you have a lot of functions of a lot of modules, you need to prepare many destructor text files for each module. This box is for utils.py. In this case, you should also prepare such .rest files for API modules and calc modules. If you have 100 modules, you should prepare 100 REST files. As you see, each REST files have just 4 lines. You can get them by repeating copy and paste and modify bit. However, I believe that you don't want to repeat that like this. Don't repeat yourself. Okay, let's use autosummary extension to avoid such a boring tasks. Set up Sphinx autosummary extension. This is your .conf.py again. Line 6 to add Sphinx X autosummary to use the extension, and line 8 to use members option for each autodoc related directive. And line 9 to generate REST files what you will specify with using autosummary directive. You can use autosummary directive in your REST file as you see. And this sample uses autosummary directive and the talktree option. The talktree option is a directive directory location of intermediate files that will be generated by autosummary. And contents of autosummary directive, deepsort.api, calc, and utils, module's name you want to document. And thereby, the autosummary, you will get 100 intermediate.rest files if you have 100 modules. After I make HTML command again. After I make HTML command again, finally you can get each documented page without forcing troublesome simple operations. Additionally, autosummary directive you wrote was generating a table of contents that linking each module's page like this. Last one is discovering undocumented APIs by using coverage extensions. So far, we've automated the autodoc by using autosummary. In addition, now you can also find the deviation of documents and implementation by using the doc test. But how do you find a function that is not not writing a docstring at all? For such situation, we can use coverage extensions to find undocumented functions, classes, and methods. To use coverage extension, you should set up coverage extension to conf.py again. Line 7, red line, to add a Sphinx X coverage to use the extension. That's all. Let's invoke make coverage. After that, you can get the result of coverage measurements. The coverage report is recorded in build_build/coverage directory. _build/coverage directory have a Python.txt file. that contains undocumented functions, classes, and modules. As you see, you can get the undocumented function name if undocumented function exists. However, please take care that command always returns zero. Make coverage command always returns zero, and then you can't distinguish the presence or absence of the undocumented function by the return code. In my opinion, it's fair enough because coverage command shouldn't fail regardless of whether coverage is perfect or not. However, unfortunately, make coverage also unsupported to generate coverage.xml for Jenkins or some CI tools. As a conclusion of this, you can discover the undocumented functions, but you can't integrate the information to CI tools. Sorry for inconvenience, and we are waiting for your contribution to solve the problem. Wrap up. Let's review the reason for not writing a docstring, and that was introduced at the beginning. I don't know what, where should I write? Okay, let's write a description argument and a docstest block as the next line of a function signature. And the second is, are there some docstrings format specs? Yes. You can use info field list for argument spec, and you can use docstest block for code example. A third one is, it's not beneficial. If you can use autodoc, autosummary, and docstest and coverage make it beneficial. I think these reasons are resolved by using Sphinx autodoc features. Until, let's write docstrings and use autodocs. Finally, on the end, I'd like to introduce some of the tips. First one is options. Options for autodoc. Autodoc have several options like this. Members is to document just specified members. If you specify the option without parameter, it means all members will be documented. And second one is under undoc under hyphen members. To document members which does not have docstrings. If you specify the option without parameter, all undocumented members are rendered. And private members option to document private members, and special members option to document a special member, like start with double underscore name, and inherited members option to document inherited from superclass. By default, Sphinx does not render inherited members, just render in the defined in the that class exactly. Please refer to Sphinx reference for the detail of options. Second one is directives for web API. Sphinx Contrib HTTP domain third-party extension provides HTTP domain to generate web API doc. As you see, you can use get directive. Here, HTTP colon get directive is used. HTTP domain also provides other HTTP related directives like HTTP colon put or delete or so on. And HTTP syntax highlighter is also provided by Sphinx contrib HTTP domain extension. It generates nice web API reference page and well-organized web API index pages like this. And Sphinx contrib HTTP domain generate a new index link at the top of Sphinx documents, and the link describes the HTTP related method index. HTTP domain also contains a Sphinx contrib.autoHTTP extension that supports Flask, Bottle, and Tornado web application framework to document web API methods automatically by using reflections. The last one is document translation. You can get translated output without editing restructured text and Python code. For that, you can use make getText command that generates getText style POT files like this. And make getText extract text from restructured text file and Python source files that referenced by autodoc. It means you can translate them into any language without rewriting the original restructured text file and Python source files. If you are interested in it, please search my PyCon APAC session in this year on SlideShare. Thanks.
Do you have some advices how to deal with a different version of your software? When I have a different, without compatibility between versions, and I need to version my Sphinx document? Does
sorry,
it make sense?
I can, I'm not very good at English. Please speak again, sorry.
Other question?
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay. So, how to deal with the different versions of your documentation? So, autodoc test is composing every time new version, and you don't save it in your subversion system or something like this, and I have different compatibility between versions of my software. So how do you have some advice or tips how to deal with different versions? Different versions of your documentation.
Sorry.
Okay. Maybe next question.
After sessions, please.
Oh, thank you. Are there other formats for docstring you're supporting, and or do you recommend the info field method?
Other format?
And other formats for docstrings than info field. Are there other formats?
Okay. Sphinx recognizes a docstring format as a restructured text, but as Sphinx 1.3 have a Napoleon extension that recognize a Google style docstring format. Then if you want to use that, you can use sphinx.x.napoleon extension.
Yeah, you showed that you can document HTTP methods within docstrings.
Uh-huh.
One tool that I'm using is Swagger, And one cool thing that it can do is that you can generate clients from it, client code, and even interactive websites that you can call the methods. Are you thinking about developing something like that from docstrings? Because that would be really, really cool.
Uh-huh. Okay. Sphinx extension that called block diag is exist, and block diag series have block figure or sequence diagram extension block SEQDIAG secdiag can describe a sequence of the flow. Then you want to figure of sequence to using API, you can use secdiag.
All right, great. Thank you, Takayuki.
Thank you.
Let's give him a big round of applause. Start next session here at 12:30.